So this is called the Titanic Switch Theory. I think I'm just going to go over a little bit about the history and then kind of what the theory was. Back when the Titanic was built, White Star Line, WSL, commissioned three ships to be made. I don't know the name of all three. I don't know the names of the two.
The other one doesn't matter. That one's a beta ship. Didn't watch Andrew Tate.
It couldn't float. It was bad at floating. The RMS Titanic and the RMS Olympic. The RMS Olympic was built first. Very important part of the story.
Okay.
It was considered the Titanic's sister ship. As I like to think, it's smoking hot twin.
Nice. But the Olympic port deck. Oh, dummy thick. I'd clap that fucking rudder anytime.
God, I would ride that ship all fucking day. So soon after the Olympic, it actually hit another ship. The Olympic actually sustained a fair amount of damage. With the costs of the repair kind of stacking up and the damage is not covered by insurance, the ship kind of became a financial burden to White Star Lines. Financial burden.
Just like I am to my parents. I get it.
You feel that. They needed to come up with a way to pay for all of these damages. Like, it's a ship. Like, it's not just, you know, like a $10 fix. Like, you can't just go down to the auto shop, pay $100, and like, she's back on the ocean. You know, this was taking time. This was taking money and resources. What the idea is what was proposed is that they could make up this money by cashing in on the insurance of one of the ships. The insurance kicks in if it's like not repairable. It's like when you crash your car and it's totaled.
I see.
That's when you could kick in. Again, this is just a theory. So
yeah.
There's plenty of holes, no pun intended.
I'll show you plenty of holes.
So like I said, they needed to figure out, I'm not going to pay attention to that. They needed to figure out how to pay for these damages. So they came up with a plan. Their plan was the sister ship, the Titanic, was just about ready to set sail across the ocean. They were like, wouldn't it be convenient if we swapped these two ships that look pretty close alike, and the one that is now swapped as the Titanic, the Olympic, were to get in an accident and be damaged beyond repair, thus they can cash in on the insurance policy, because it was believed that the Titanic was overinsured. They could actually make money off doing this. Not only did the damages paid for, but they could make like a shit ton of money.
Yeah.
This is kind of how like the plan was laid out. They do the swap, void out to sea, accidentally hit an iceberg, get everyone off the ship safely, and then they'd have a standby ship in the area, the SS, whatever, California. Ship sinks, everyone gets to safety on the next boat, and then they cash in on that sweet insurance money. That was their plan. However, we all know something else happened. The Titanic, aka the Olympic, actually did hit an iceberg. They had this other ship that was supposedly on standby in the area that could pick everyone up. However, this ship actually was docked for that whole night because there was a bunch of icebergs in the area and they were like, nah, we're not gonna fuck with that. We were canceling all of our shit tonight because we knew that there was like an iceberg warning. So what ended up happening is what the story of that we all know. Here's where I get into holes in this theory. First off, the ships weren't identical. The plans for each ship are very, very different. The rooms are different. The layout's different. They are not the same ship. They were like loosely based off each other. Anyone who like working on it, building it, workers on the ship, they would fucking know. There's no way that those people wouldn't be like, this isn't the fucking Titanic.
Yeah.
This is the Olympic. Like, the fuck? What also goes along with this theory, they had to switch all of the stuff inside the boats because every boat has a serial number. It's called a hull number. The Titanic's hull number is 401. The Olympic's is 400. And everything inside of ships will have that number on it. Desks, chairs, stoves, pictures, everything. So in order for this theory to work, they would have had to switch everything out into a ship that wasn't identical and have to do this secretively. Imagine taking everything from one like cruise liner and putting it into another. That's bodies. That's people that have to do that.
Yeah.
That's time.
Somebody would have.
That's out in the harbor. That's both the ships. That's both the ships being together in one place at the same time. Which I think there's also evidence that they were only together for this amount of time. Like this. Like it, there's.
It,
they just.
But it wouldn't have been a sufficient.
They were not obviously parked next to each other for a long time.
Like
so,
that would take probably days.
Weeks.
Weeks, yeah.
Weeks. It's kind of like common sense sort of things. Like I didn't think about it either. I was like, oh yeah, like you need people. What are you telling these people? What are you telling them that they're doing? The big one for me, the insurance policy on the Titanic. In the theory, there's an idea that the Titanic is overinsured, that like if we sink this thing, we're making money. That is not at all true. The Titanic was in fact underinsured. The insurance policy, you'd get popped out $5 million for sinking the Titanic, which would in this case would be the Olympic. It was 7.5 million to build. So you're actually losing money.
Yeah.
If you sink this ship. In the end, I very much so now do not believe the switch theory, just based off kind of those no-brainer financial and logistical holes in this story. It just doesn't seem like it could happen.